Mirabel, stop pacing around. It's distracting. Sorry, sis. I'm just anxious. What do you have to be anxious about? It's not like your family is forcing you to get married to someone you don't love. What? Are you talking about Mariano? Hey, sis, you shouldn't be saying things like that. If Abuela hears you... Frankly, I'm a bit tired of Abuela and her ideas these days. Does she ever listen to what I want? What are you talking about? You're Abuela's favorite. I've been trying to get her to like me for years. Favorite? I think not. If I'm really her golden child like what people think I am, then I would get to decide my own future. Marrying Mariano isn't that bad. His family is rich. His mom owns the Colombian coffee empire. You'll be taken care of. You'll be his wife, have kids.
No one asks me whether I want kids.
I want to be a businesswoman like Mariano's mother. Businesswoman? What do you know about running a business?
I just made something unexpected. Something sharp. Something new. I grow rows and rows of roses for the mile, by the mile. I make perfect practice poses, so much height behind my smile. What could I do if I just grew what I was feeling in the moment? What could I do if I just knew it didn't need to be perfect? Just needed to be, and it let me be. A hurricane of jacarandas, strangling figs, hanging vines. Palma de cera fills the air as I climb and I push through. What else can I do?
Sis, I think this is the first time you've spoken your mind, like ever. I wish we could talk like this more often. You're always prancing around and conjuring flowers as Señorita Perfecta. I didn't know you felt trapped.
That's a familiar feeling. Don't worry, sis. Mirabel and I will help you.
How? How can you kids convince Abuela to let me break the engagement?
With data science, of course. Data science? I was just doing my chores for the villagers the other day. As I was tending to the donkeys, I heard the villagers talking about your engagement, Isa.
What did they say?
Mirabel, go distract Abuela while Isa and I try to come up with a solution.
Okie dokie, easy peasy. Maybe I can unleash a dumb bone? That will distract her, alright.
Nothing too extreme. The Guzmans are coming.
Stop worrying. Leave it to me.
Okay, where were we? Ah, as I was saying, I heard the villagers talking about you. Each of them have an opinion. I was so bored with the donkeys, so I collected some data.
Data? How much data are we talking about?
Well, I have data for over 1,000 villagers. I've recorded 18 data items, or variables as people say. Take a look, sis.
They got it right. I want to become a florist. How dare some people think I'd want to become a housewife?
I know, right? Us girls can be anything we want. So the ambition column is the outcome variable. You're either a florist or a housewife.
Ugh, what are the other columns?
A range of different things, really. Like how many minutes you've been practicing your gift of conjuring flowers, how pretty your flowers look, that's the variable score flower. How good your cooking tastes, for score cooking.
How good my food tastes? What, is that like a measure of how good a housewife I'm gonna be? These people gossip too much.
I agree, but it's good that they gossip. Otherwise, I won't have data to present to Abuela to fight our case.
Well, okay then. So what do we do next?
First, we use the create data partition function from the Caret package to split the train and test datasets using an 80-20 ratio.
I thought we used the random sample function previously.
Yes, we did, but the create data partition function is better because it preserves the proportion of categories in the response variable, which is ambition. You have to have similar proportions of the response variable in the train and test datasets.
Come on, Luisa, let's take a look at some descriptive statistics. We can use the skim function from the skimmer package. Whoa, I can see that we have missing values. Is this a problem, sis?
Not at all. We can simply impute missing values using the pre-process function.
What do you mean by impute missing values?
Impute means to replace missing values with some meaningful values. It predicts missing values by considering the rest of the available variables as predictors using the k-nearest neighbors algorithm.
What's the k-nearest neighbors?
The k-nearest neighbors algorithm imputes missing data by finding the k-closest neighbors to the observations with missing data and then imputing them based on non-missing values in the neighbors. First, we create the KNN imputation model on the train dataset using the pre-process function.
Then, I think we can use the imputation model to predict the values of the missing data points.
That's right. We can simply run the predict function on the imputation model.
It looks like we have one categorical variable called PRACLOC7 to indicate whether the practice location is called 7, yes or no.
Categorical variables need to be converted to numeric in order for it to be used by machine learning algorithms. And instead of just replacing the categories with any number, it may not be meaningful, especially if there is no intrinsic ordering among the categories. So what we do instead is to convert the categorical variable with as many binary 1 or 0 variables as they are categories.
Oh, I see. I think this is called one-hot encoding. And the caret package allows us to do that using the dummy vars function. All we need to do is to pass all the variables to the dummy vars function, and all the categorical variables will be automatically converted to one-hot encodings.
That's right. In our case, we have one categorical variable called PRACLOC7 with two categories. So, it is one hot encoded to produce two new columns, PRACLOC7 yes and PRACLOC7 no.
Now that we have imputed the missing values and one hot encoded the categorical variables, we can normalize all the numeric values so that they range between 0 and 1 using the pre-process function and specifying the method as range.
Why do we need to normalize the data?
So that it is easier to interpret if everything falls between 0 and 1. Plus, it helps declutter graphs and provides better visualization, especially for variables that are not evenly distributed across the parameters. Another reason is to meet statistical assumptions. Like for linear regression, an important assumption is homoscedasticity. Check out the Quidditch and Chocolate Frogs episode for more details.
Now that we have transformed the data, we can visualize the importance of variables using the feature plot function.
Oh, so we can examine how predictor variables influence the outcome variable, which is ambition?
Indeed, we can see if a predictor variable is an important predictor of ambition by looking for shifts in the mean values using box plots and density plots. Take a look at the box plots.
That is so cool, Luisa. So the black dot inside the blue box is the mean?
Yes. Take a look at the support florist subplot, which measures the loyalty score of villagers to your ambition of becoming a florist. The black dots and the placement of the two boxes are very different. So I'm quite sure that the support florist variable is going to be an important predictor.
It looks like score diff, a flower, and score cooking are also quite different based on the changes in the position of the black dots.
I think so. We can also plot density curves by specifying plot equals to density.
As expected, the density curves pink and blue for support florist, score diff, a flower, and score cooking look very different.
Isabela, the Guzmans are here. Mariano is here. I told you to get ready, but your hair is still in the mess.
Sorry, Abuela. Yes, Abuela. I'll go freshen up. Sis, let's pick this up later, okay? I need to entertain the in-laws.
Okay, sir. Go, go, go.